Solitude indicates a fresh mind. In the life we generally lead, there is very little solitude. Even when we are alone, our lives are crowded by so many influences, so much knowledge, so many memories of so many experiences, so much anxiety, misery and conflict that our minds become duller and duller, more and more insensitive, functioning in a monotonous routine. Are we ever alone? Or are we carrying with us all the burdens of yesterday? There is a rather nice story of two monks walking from one village to another, and they come upon a young girl sitting on the bank of a river, crying. And one of the monks goes up to her and says, "Sister, what are you crying about?" She says, "You see that house over there across the river? I came over this morning early and had no trouble wading across, but now the river has swollen and I can't get back. There is no boat." "Oh," says the monk, "that is no problem at all," and he picks her up and carries her across the river and leaves her on the other side. And the two monks go on together. After a couple of hours, the other monk says, "Brother, we have taken a vow never to touch a woman. What you have done is a terrible sin. Didn't you have pleasure, a great sensation, in touching a woman?" And the other monk replies, "I left her behind 2 hours ago. You are still carrying her, aren't you?" That is what we do. We carry our burdens all the time, we never die to them, we never leave them behind. It is only when we give complete attention to a problem and solve it immediately, never carrying it over to the next day, the next minute, that there is solitude. Then, even if we live in a crowded house or are in a bus, we have solitude. And that solitude indicates a fresh mind, an innocent mind.